Hello guys, welcome to Bhavna's Online Academy. In this video, we are going to discuss the CA Inter Paper Number 8, Financial Management and Economics for Finance Paper Analysis. In this video, we are going to discuss the past 10 attempts question papers, and we have made analysis out of which, by which we can easily and short score 70 plus marks in your examination. And in this video, I've also covered how you have to study for your FM economics paper and what is the question paper pattern is also discussed in the end. So before moving into this FM eco analysis, just remember that the remaining 7 papers analysis is also up on my channel. Please do check them out. It is going to be one of the best analysis series you have come across, and I can assure you that. So without any further ado, let's get into the video, guys. Yes. So starting with your past exam analysis. So before that, you need to know what is your paper pattern in the examination. So before we get into the analysis, let me give you a brief of what is the question paper pattern in your examination. So FM comes for 60 marks in your examination, and your economics comes for 40 marks in your examination. FM is covering 60 marks and economics is covering 40 marks. In FM, you have both practical and theory. In your economics also, you have both practical and theory. So in your FM, please concentrate on your practical part. In your economics also, let's concentrate on the practical part, and to boost up our scores, we'll concentrate on the theory part too. Yes. So first, let me tell you what is the question paper pattern of financial management. So in your financial management paper, you are totally going to be asked 6 questions, out of which your question number 1 is going to be a compulsory question, which is going to come for 20 marks. In this first compulsory question, you will be given 4 questions for 5 marks each. So you have to attend 4 questions which are going to be your 5 marks and which will give you 20 marks. And first question is a compulsory question. Apart from that, you are going to be given around 5 questions, out of which any 4 questions you have to attempt. Any 4 questions you have to attempt out of this 5 questions, and that will give you 60 marks in the examination. These remaining 5 questions, each question is going to come for 10 marks. Correct. And your question number 6 in your financial management paper is going to be a theory question. So I would suggest you that do not read this theory question at all. Just attempt until this and you will fetch your 60 marks. Don't concentrate on theory in your FM paper. No need to study theory. Okay. Now moving on with your economics paper, like I told you, there's both practical and theory. Practical is being asked for minimum 10 marks. I guarantee 10 marks it's going to come in your examination. And it can extend up to a range of 15 to 20 marks also. Yes, so practical, that is about your economics practical, and the rest will come for theory. So in your economics also, totally what happens, your question number 7, that is your first question of your economics paper, it is a question number 7. So here it ends with question number 6, and then it is continued as question number 7. It is a compulsory question which has come for 10 marks in your examination. And from the rest 4 questions, any 3 questions you have to attempt, and each question is again for 10 marks, and which will give you 40 marks in total. So this is your FM eco question paper pattern. Yes. So now that you have understood the question paper pattern, let's start with your past exam analysis. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to first show you the past exam analysis. As you can see here, for FM also I've made an analysis, for economics also I've made an analysis. So before starting with that, let me tell you what is the strategy we are going to follow. What is the strategy we are going to follow for your FM and eco? So like I told you, financial management paper treated like a practical paper, no need to study theory. So in financial management paper, I am going to tell you 4 golden chapters. I'm going to tell you 4 golden chapters which is coming for every attempt in your examination. Every attempt, these 4 golden chapters are going to be asked. And if you just read this 4 golden chapters, out of 60 marks of your FM paper, 30 marks you'll be able to definitely cover. Sure, 30 marks. It can even come for more marks, but minimum 30 marks are guaranteed. So read 4 chapters, get 30 marks. After doing that, when it comes for economics, so economics, you have what? You have your practical, and then you have your theory. What I would suggest is that economics you need to study fully. Economics you need to study fully. Okay. So practical 10 marks you'll be able to cover. Theory 30 marks you'll be able to cover. So 40 marks here also. So totally 30 marks in your financial management and 40 marks in your economics. This is how we are going to score 70 plus marks in your examination. This is how we are going to score 70 plus in your examination. I'll come in detail about how you have to go about this. But now first, let's go and find out what are the 4 golden chapters in your financial management. Yes. So in your financial management, you have totally 10 chapters. You have totally 10 chapters in your ICI study material. So here one point that you have to remember is you no need to study your chapter number 1 and chapter number 2 because these both are theory chapters. You need not study these theory chapters. Even without reading that, you can easily crack your FM paper. Don't concentrate on theory. So now we are left with other 8 chapters. Out of these 8 chapters, there are 4 golden chapters which I'm going to discuss. The first is your ratio analysis. Yes. So if you see here, if you see on your screen, I'll tell you what this is. So starting from your May 2018 until your November 2022, 10 attempts of question paper I've analyzed here. So like I told you, question number 1, A, B, C, D, 4 questions are being asked and this is your compulsory question. Then you have your question number 2, question number 3, question number 4 and question number 5. So what I've done here is, I've given you each question from which chapter it has been asked in every attempt. So starting from May 2018 until November 2022, from which chapter each question has been asked, I've given you an analysis here. Please take a screenshot of this. It is going to be very helpful for your examination. So ratio chapter is your first important chapter, which has come for minimum 5 marks compulsory in every attempt. So if you see starting from May 18, it has been marked in orange color. November 18, November 19, 19, 20, 21, 22 attempt, 22 attempt. And wherever it has not come in the compulsory part, so wherever it has not come in the compulsory part, it has come in the bigger mark. That is for 10 marks in those attempts, it has been questioned. So minimum 5 marks in compulsory or 10 marks it is going to be asked. So that is the first important chapter. The second important chapter is your leverages. The second important chapter is your leverages. In every attempt for 10 marks, it is being questioned. So leverages, here I marked it in blue color. Here I have marked it in blue color. If you see, apart from May 2018, in all the attempts, November 18, November 19, May 19, November 19, 20, 21, 22, in all the attempts, it has come for 10 marks. It has come in the 10 mark section in every single attempt. In one attempt alone, it came for 5 marks. So an average marks of 10 from leverage chapter, an average marks of 10 you can definitely expect in your paper also, because if you can see, blue is there in every single attempt except for May, November 20. Every single attempt leverage question has come for 10 marks. In your exam also you can expect the same. The next important chapter is your investment decision, and the last important chapter will be your risk analysis. Yes, so these both are very interconnected chapters and both come in the examination for around 15 marks. So investment decision comes for 10 marks. Risk analysis usually comes in the compulsory question for 5 marks. Yes, so I marked that in green color. So this green color also, you can see it all over the paper, all over the last 10 attempts. So there has been no single attempt in which these both chapters have not come. Either it has come in capital budgeting, usually you see it has come in the important question 5 mark, that is compulsory question 5 mark, and investment decision usually comes in the 10 mark category. In the 10 mark category, November 2022, the 20 marks it came, investment decision. Okay, so very important chapter. Again, if you do investment decision, 10 marks is locked here, and risk analysis, if you do, 5 marks is locked there. So 30 marks short shot. So if you see, in every attempt, these important chapters come for 30 marks. In the last November 2022, it was question for 40 marks in your examination. So these are your 4 golden chapters which you have to do very well, which is your ratio analysis, leverages, investment decisions and risk analysis. Okay, now how are you going to do this? Because a few students feel the investment decision chapter to be very tough, correct? So what you can do is, you can go to the playlist of my channel. I have made a financial management crash course on my channel. If you go in the financial management crash course, here whatever chapters have been marked in blue color, those chapters are uploaded on my channel. Those chapters are all uploaded on my channel and you can take benefit of those videos to understand these chapters. Yes. The playlist is given here, and investment decision, importantly, I've covered it very, very well. I've covered all concepts of investment decisions, plus I've covered the illustration, plus I've covered the test your knowledge question. So all of this I've covered on my channel. Investment decision is a must to watch if you don't understand this chapter yet very well. I'm very sure it can give you a good conceptual clarity. So definitely check out that playlist. Yes. Now coming to your economics analysis. If you see here, you have your economics analysis. So economics, you have 4 chapters totally. And the 4 chapters, if you see from your May 2018 until your December 2021, all the chapters are almost asked in every single attempt for around the same weightage only. So if you see an average of, so this is your chapter number 1, chapter number 2, chapter number 3 and chapter number 4. So an average of 12 marks comes from chapter 1, 11 marks from chapter 2, chapter 3, 13 marks, chapter 4, 16 marks. But if you can see here, an average of 10 to 12 marks from every chapter it is being questioned. An average of 10 to 12 marks is being questioned from every single chapter. So all the four chapters in economics are very, very important. Yes, understood? Okay, fine. So here if you see, what you need to understand here is that your all the chapters, like if you see chapter number 2, chapter number 3 and chapter number 4, if you go to my channel, in my channel playlist, the theory part of these three chapters have been uploaded. So public finance I've covered in 1 hour, money market in half an hour, and international market in 1 hour. If you just spend 2.5 hours on these three chapters theory in my channel video, it is more than enough to answer the theory questions coming in the examination. Okay. Apart from that, economics numericals also covering all the four chapters. I've covered it in a 2.5 hours video, which is there on my channel. So definitely check out that economics numerical videos also. So totally 5 hours of economic playlist you will find on my channel for economics for finance. Definitely use that for your benefit. Yes. So I hope you understood this also. So if you have to mention what is the important units for numericals in your chapter number 1, unit 1 and unit 2, in your chapter number 2, unit 4 and in your chapter number 3, unit 2. These four units are the most important four units for your numericals, and most of the questions are being asked from these four units only. So do these four units very well if you want to crack your numericals. Okay. Yes. So now that we have discussed everything about FM and economics paper, let me tell you what is the best way to go about studying your FM eco paper. Your economics paper, you need to read both theory as well as practical sums. As I've already told you, for theory, you can use summary notes and study and also take help of my videos like I mentioned earlier. For sums, what you can do is, until your Jan 21 attempts, that is for the first 6 attempts from May 2018 until your Jan 2021, I have made a video covering all the previous year questions as well as your RTP questions for sums and solve that. So you can do that. And for your last 4 attempts, you can do self. And when it comes for financial management, do all your study material questions. And along with that, if you're able to cover your practice manual from the old syllabus, do that. If you don't have this practice manual from your old syllabus, then previous year questions and your RTP questions for the last 3 to 4 attempts is a must cover. And importantly, for the category A chapters, golden chapters that I told you, must cover for your RTP and previous year question that you have to must cover. Yes. So I hope this analysis was clear to you all. And yes, I have a lot of hard work has actually gone into making each of this analysis for all the 8 papers. The analysis you see here on the screen is just for 10 to 12 minutes long, but around 10 hours I have spent on each analysis, making each and every single analysis. The research has taken around 10 hours for every paper. I have spent around 80 hours. If you go approximate. So I would really like if you would comment down below and let me know if this analysis series was truly helpful to you. I'll feel very motivated to do more such things for you all. Yes, guys. So let's end it here. You also please join my Telegram channel, for which the link will be in the description box below, as I keep on updating the new videos or the new series that I'm going to come up with. And yes, thank you so much for watching till the end. If you like this video, please make sure to like, share and also subscribe to the channel. And thank you so much, guys. See you in the next video. Bye bye.